Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to the properties of group 2 elements such as atomic radius, solubility, reactivity, ionization energy, etc. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question 14. The statements apply to the elements in group 2. Which statement is correct? A. As atomic number increases, ionic radius increases. Yes, we know that in going down in the group 2, what happens that in each period another shell is added, so therefore ionic radius increases. This is correct. As atomic number increases, reducing ability decreases. No, this is wrong, because reducing ability increases because elements can easily lose electrons down in group 2. As atomic number increases, first ionization energy increases. Now, as the atomic size increases, the first ionization energy actually decreases because the attraction between the outermost electron and the nucleus becomes less. D says, as atomic radius increases, first ionization energy increases. So this is also wrong. So the only correct option is A. Question 13. This question is about two elements in group 2, Q and R. Three of the statements shown are correct for metal Q. The one remaining statement is correct for metal R. Which statement applies to R? Let's first write the elements of group 2. We have beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, and barium. Let's move towards the statement. A. A saturated solution of the hydroxide of this metal has a higher pH value. Now we can say that the hydroxides of group 2 become more soluble moving down in group. So more soluble hydroxide means more higher pH, so it could be barium. B. This metal has a carbonate that is used in agriculture to reduce the acidity of soil. Now we can see that the carbonates of group 2 become more stable as we move down in the group. So it means barium carbonate is difficult to decompose, so it won't be barium carbonate. It could be calcium carbonate, because we know that calcium carbonate forms calcium hydroxide, which reduces the acidity of the soil. C. This metal has greater atomic radius. As we know that the number of shells increase down in the group, so therefore barium would have the greatest atomic radius. So it could be barium. D. This metal reacts more quickly with cold water. The reactivity of group 2 metals also increase down the group with water, so therefore it should be barium. So A, C and D, these three properties are for barium, while B is for calcium carbonate, while B is for calcium. So metal Q is barium and R will be calcium. The correct option for calcium is B. Question number 18. What are the trends in the stated properties as group 2 is descended from magnesium to barium? First is the decomposition temperature of the carbonate. As we know that in group 2, the carbonates become more stable down the group. This is because size of cation increases. And as the size of anion is already greater, which is carbonate anion, so therefore the bond formed becomes stronger as the size of both cation and anion become equal. So it should be increases. Second is the first ionization energy. As we know that in group 2, the size of element increases down the group. This is because in each period one shell is added. So the first ionization energy is the removal of electron from the outermost shell. So when the outermost shell is away from the nucleus, then the ionization energy will decrease. So the first ionization energy decreases down the group. The answer is therefore D. Question number 14. Metal T reacts with water to produce a colorless solution. A white precipitate is produced when this colorless solution is mixed with aqueous sulfuric acid. What is metal T? Let's look at the options. A is barium. Barium reacts with water to form colorless solution of barium hydroxide. So this is true. Barium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid to form precipitate of barium sulfate. So both options are correct for barium, so it could be the possible answer. B is magnesium. Magnesium reacts with water to form magnesium hydroxide. And this is not a colorless solution. And magnesium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid to form magnesium sulfate, which is a soluble solid. So therefore, option B is incorrect. C is potassium. Potassium reacts with water to form a colorless solution of potassium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid to form potassium sulfate, which is soluble. So therefore, option C is also incorrect. For sodium, we have sodium hydroxide in water and sodium sulfate in sulfuric acid. Again, sodium sulfate is soluble. So therefore, D is also incorrect. The correct option is barium A. Question number 16. L, M and N are group 2 metals. L reacts more vigorously with dilute hydrochloric acid than N. M hydroxide is more soluble than N hydroxide. What could be the identities of L, M and N? In this question, they have given just three elements: calcium, strontium and barium. So according to group 2 sequence, we can write them as calcium, then strontium, then barium. The reactivity of group 2 increases down the group. As in the question, it says L reacts more vigorously than N. So therefore, it means L is below N. We also know that the solubility of hydroxide of group 2 metals down the group increases. In the question, they say that M hydroxide is more soluble than N hydroxide. It means M is below N. So as N is both above L and M, so we can say that N could be calcium. Let's look at the options. In N, we have strontium, calcium, strontium, barium. So therefore, correct option is B. Question 36. Which properties increase from magnesium to barium? Both elements, magnesium and barium, are present in the same group. We have magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. First point is that ionic radius of cation M plus 2 increases. As we can see that in every period successive shell is added, so it means that the size of cation will also increase as the number of shells increase. So 1 is correct. 2. Screening of outermost electrons by inner shells also increase. As screening depends on the number of shells between nucleus and outermost electron, as we can see that the number of shells increase as we move down in the group. So therefore, screening will also increase. 3. Solubility of hydroxides in water.
Now we can say that magnesium hydroxide is less soluble in water as compared to barium hydroxide. This is because solubility of group 2 increases down the group. So third part is also correct. As all three options are correct, the answer is therefore A. Question 15. In which row are all statements comparing magnesium and barium are correct? First is the fourth ionization energy and second is the reaction with water. Now magnesium and barium are in same group of the periodic table in which magnesium is on top and barium is at bottom. So as we move down the group, size of atom increases. So therefore ionization energy decreases. As it is easy to remove an electron from a larger atom as compared to smaller atom. So therefore the ionization energy of barium will be lower than magnesium. Second thing is reactivity with water. As we move down in the group, the reactivity of group 2 metals increase. So barium is more reactive with water as compared to magnesium. So therefore barium reaction will be faster and magnesium will be slower. Correct answer is therefore B.
Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe and share.